Hello everyone, I'm joined by Sauna from Virtus Pro to talk about Stage 4 playoffs today. And I wanted to start, Sauna, because you've had no roster changes going into this final stage, but you have got Smashback, so how do you rope him back in?
I feel like convinced management that we're going to need Smash, and they made it happen. And we also like started moving our scrims, like we start at 5 now. So it's like, it's not middle of night for Smash.
Okay, then.
So it's doable for him.
And obviously, on paper, you had probably your best results of the year, really, under Smash. What does he bring to the team in terms of what he adds from a coaching perspective?
Just brings a third perspective. Like, if it's just the players, we're just going to argue about it and, like, flip-flop between decisions every 2 seconds, but I think it's good that one guy has, like, the final say.
And then I want to ask a little bit, because we saw you guys play in Face It playoffs, but you didn't have Shockwave at the time, but you did have Shockwave back for the Stage 4 group stage. How is it going to work in this current meta, obviously? Because we've seen a lot of teams play in May, which is obviously a hero Cloud's very strong on. How is it going to work between the three of you and the sort of who's in for what on the DPS?
Still kind of figuring that out, but like you can usually tell if heat scan's good or not. So if heat scan's like really bad on a map, then we just like might play double flex. But we still haven't like fully decided yet.
And then I wanted to ask a bit about supports as well, because Juno Brig is being played by most teams in most situations. You've obviously got two supports who are both pretty comfortable on the more sort of aim heavy or mechanical heavy heroes. How did you go about picking who's going to Juno, who's going to Brig out of a pair of them?
I mean, at the start, we were trying to force Anna Juno. So we put Genile on Anna and Gallus playing Juno. So we kind of just kept that, and now Genile's playing Brig and Gallus on Juno. So I think it's working out pretty well.
I wanted to ask a bit about you as well specifically, because I feel like the sort of biggest highs you've had this year have really come playing a lot of Tracer. But in the current meta, we see way more heroes like Genji, Mei, maybe a bit of Pharah, Echo being played a lot more. How do you rate yourself currently on those heroes, maybe compared to your Tracer or compared to other players in the region?
I mean, obviously, it's not like those heroes you can't like carry as much. It's like more team oriented. So it's like you're not going to have as much impact on like a Mei compared to a Tracer. So it's just more team play.
Do you think overall that's then that sort of limits the impact you can have in the game compared to maybe previous metas as well then?
Yeah, I would say so. But now it's like trending towards the Genji one, so it's like you can do more stuff on Genji compared to me, so I think it's good.
And I wanted to ask as well, Orisa very much seems to be in the meta for a lot of teams. But it's not a hero I think I have a very strong memory of seeing Rajaro on. How's Rajaro finding the move onto Orisa, and how does he sort of stack up?
I think he's been improving a lot. Like, with Smash, he's been, like, working with him. It's been helping a lot. I think he's getting better, for sure.
And then, as we go into the tournament itself, you're going to be up against Vendetta first. How do you feel expectations going into that one? Are you worried it'll maybe be a W Ange kind of moment, or can you overturn that?
I'm hoping it's a W Ange for us, but like, I think we should win that if we want to make Stockholm. Like,
and the way it's set up right now in terms of the qualification for Stockholm is you're actually in control of your own fate, right? As long as you finish above Twisted Minds and Piece of Cake, you should be okay from a circuit point. POV, how confident do you feel that you will be able to get that result?
Yeah, I think we should finish over TM and Piece of Cake. I think we don't the mat, like, they have to finish, like, if they finish third and we get fourth, I think we still go through.
Yeah.
But they have to get, like, second and we have to finish fourth for them to get through. Like, they have to, like, pop off, which I think is kind of hard for them, because I think SSG and Ernst are, like, pretty good on this patch. They're going to probably be top 2, unless we punch up, but we'll see.
Who do you think's the scarier for two teams then in this meta than out of Twisted Minds and Piece of Cake?
Probably Piece of Cake, because they have like they can play more stuff. I feel like they can play the Mage stuff if they want. They can play the Genji stuff as well. They also beat DM. Like it was pretty convincing in the group stage. So I would say them.
And then, how do you feel? Like you said, SSG and Ents very much normally seen at the top of sort of hierarchy is it for everyone in Europe. How close do you think you are to those sort of two top teams in this meta?
I think, like, if you're a team that always shits the bed in scrims but plays better in officials, so I think scrimbox for us are gonna fake, so it's, like, kinda hard to say right now. But I think if it's official, like, anything can happen. So I think we're, like, in the top three still, though.
Okay. And then, really, we've seen you guys play a lot of your own style throughout the year, leaning into the double flex stuff. Now we're in a meta where it feels like everyone is sort of compelled to play mostly the same comps, and it's a very brawl-heavy matchup. How do you feel your team compares playing that type of matchup compared to maybe some of the stuff you played in the past?
I mean, obviously, it doesn't, like, lean into our strengths as much, but, like, I think we still have the skill to, like, compete with other teams in it. It's not that hard, like, it's a brawl meta. Like, just go first. Go kill.
And who in the team is really, like, whenever you get to these brawly metas, it's always super important the team is on the same page, listening, moving together, in at the same time, out at the same time, all of this. Who's the person in your team who really sort of takes over the control of nose pushes?
It's honestly a team effort, but usually we have, like, if someone has an ult, they, like, plan out their own ult. And recently we've been trying to make Rajaro, like, the in-game leader a bit. Because he's the one going in on Risa, so probably him or team effort. Shockwave's also, like, really welcome on his scan. So, but it's kind of, you don't want your hit scan to yap. You want him to shoot heads. So it's like, you're trying to pivot away from that.
How's it going with Rajaro? Because whenever I've spoken to Rajaro, I've kind of got the impression of the sort of stereotypical quiet Finnish man.
I think he's doing pretty well. Like, we've been limit testing in scrims, just going first. I think it's going fine. Getting better every day.
And then, if I had to get you to put your money where your mouth was, who's going to win this stage? And you can't say your own team. Who's the strongest team in the region right now?
I'm betting on Ents.
Ents? Okay, not SSG? Yeah.
Nah, not SSG. Okay. I think, unless SSG has, like, a ace up their sleeve, I think Ents is going to win.
Oh, okay. Okay. Most people have said SSG so far. I think you're the first Ents believer.
I'm an Ents believer.
Yeah. All right, then. Thank you very much, Sauna. I do appreciate your time. Good luck, of course, to you and the team and your bid to try and qualify for Stockholm. We'll see you on the weekend.
All right. Thanks for having me.